Antler, the man with antlers. He tosses evildoers like a chef tosses a salad. He headbutts criminals like a righteous goat. And he gives bad guys hard-to-follow directions to banks.
Oh, boy.
George, long day tomorrow. Turn out the light.
Mantler only turns out evildoers' lights.
Yeah, but after that, he goes to sleep, right?
Mantler never sleeps.
His roommate must be thrilled.
Why do they put these factory outlet malls so far away from everything? That's why they call this bargain hunting.
George doesn't get shopping.
Don't you want to buy things?
George only wants the new Mantler comic, issue 107, Mantler's Difficult Decision, with special appearances by Gail, the gal with a tail.
Molten lava? Well, that's just great.
Mantler would make still. Hot, burnt out, blister, singe! No! Maybe George could toss the girls over, same way Mantler tosses evildoers out of Jungle Tropolis.
Is anyone else a little tired of hearing about a certain comic book?
George isn't tired. In issue 102?
Check the map for a shortcut.
Mantler always says, you're never lost as long as you're with happy friends. Mantler's antlers start twitching when he's going the wrong way. Ow! But George has is a leg cramp.
No more Mantler!
My feet hurt because I didn't get to shop for new hiking boots.
Sure wish George looked at that map. Sure wish George knew what Mantler's difficult decision is. Sure wish George... Wow! A falling star! Aw,
pretty.
George wishes a star would fall every night.
You say a big fiery rock crushed your house. All right, where did this rock come from?
The sky!
That sky?
How'd you guess?
Sounds a lot like the falling star George saw last night.
The first one to see a falling star gets their wish. Did you wish for anything?
Oh, George should have wished for the new Mantler comic book instead of a star to fall every night.
Every night, huh? Interesting.
What are the chances of a house that small being hit by a shooting star?
If George's wish came true, another one would have fallen last night and somebody would have seen it and made the wish.
Hey, sorry I didn't get a hold of you. I've been wiring the games room with surround sound all morning.
Where did this all come from?
I stayed up last night waiting for George's shooting star and blah-da! Oh, hey, guys, help yourself to the swimming pools.
Last night's shooting star destroyed the gorilla's soccer field. George, do you know what this means?
Someone's gonna have to teach them basketball?
It means, thanks to your wish, stars will fall every night until someone wishes for them to stop.
Well, that's a relief. Finding basketball shoes to fit a gorilla is impossible.
Later that night...
Hey, that must have been the star.
Ooh, I hope it didn't hit Mongoose's swimming pool. The hippo health spa's been destroyed!
That's not fair. I had a yoga class.
Dudes, check me out!
Yo, someone chipped Louie's ride.
I kind of saw that star last night. Couldn't help myself. Sorry. But look at this baby! Video console in every seat and... an onboard frozen yogurt dispenser!
Oh, termite and earthworm swirl. Oh, yeah.
Have we forgotten we're trying to stop giant fiery meteors from destroying the jungle?
But look at all the cup holders!
I'll sit up tonight with my dad's telescope and straighten this whole thing out. It's not what you think. Satellite TV brings us weather reports and, news of...
What time is it? My soap opera is about to start. Everybody out. I don't want you to see me cry.
Okay. I guess it's up to me to handle this once and for all.
Gee, Magnolia, glad to see you took care of things.
I couldn't help it.
A walk-in closet with robotic shoe storage?
With temperature control and a frozen yogurt dispenser.
Someone has to show a little backbone around here.
That leaves out the slugs and worms.
I meant me. I'm gonna wish for these stars to stop coming tonight. I'm the only one with any willpower around here.
I'm the mayor of Banana Mountain! Whee! Woo-hoo!
Whee! And so, night after night, and falling star after falling star, no one in the jungle had the strength to stop them.
George, you got us into this. You're going to have to get us out of it.
Oh, it's that bad, huh?
Must stay awake. Must wish for shooting stars to stop. And not frozen yogurt. Mantler?
Hello, George of the Jungle. It is I, Mantler, the man with antlers. You look tired. I know all about tired. Remember when I fought the gazelle twins? Who knew there were three of them?
Oh, sure was a great comic. Would you happen to have a copy of the latest one?
Sorry, sold out. The only way you could get one would be if you had a, I don't know, a magic wish or something.
Oh, can you just tell George what your big decision was?
It was about responsibility. I think you know something about that too, George. It was my best issue ever. Well, I'm off to fight for steadfastness and responsibility. Maybe get a burger.
Best issue ever.
Best issue ever. Best issue ever.
Responsibility.
Best issue ever. Responsibility.
Oh. George wishes for... Oh, Mantler and...
George, no!
Ape? What are you doing up here? And where'd you get those cool antlers?
I'm not Ape, George. I'm your conscience.
Wow. Where'd George's conscience get those cool antlers?
George, as your conscience, we demand that you wish for no more shooting stars.
Boy, bossy conscience.
George, are you having visions of everyone but me?
Wish wisely, George. I should mention that issue 107 is probably my best flight sequence ever. And the puppy I save is adorable.
What does George do? What does George do? George will wish for the new mantle. Mantler. George wishes for...
So, George, how did it go?
It went okay.
Yay! Yeah! Hooray! We knew you could do it. No more wishing stars from now on.
Actually, not just from now on.
What do you mean?
George wished he'd never seen shooting star in the first place.
But that would undo everyone's wishes.
My closet!
George sort of feels sorry for the animals.
It's all for the best. Probably.
Maybe one of them will see another shooting star someday.
Hey, Chef, what you got there? Is that... That looks like a genie's magic lamp!
Wait a minute. Shep, That means you have two more wishes.
In the jungle,
here boy.
Nothing is more heartwarming than the love between a boy and his dog.
Strange. Somebody keeps stealing inside part of banana.
Go get the banana! Go get the banana!
Look out!
General, the top of HQ has been destroyed!
Who did it, Corporal?
An elephant! The one belonging to George, King of the Jungle!
Good job, Shep. One last throw. Aw, who's cute? Anteater is. Are you ticklish, Anteater? Shep, George played with you all morning. Now it's Anteater's turn. Shep, it's not nap time. We have to take this little guy home. There you go. I'll bet your mom has a nice warm batch of ants at home. Baby anteater, George told you to go home. Oh, George sucker for big eyes. In life and in art. George will keep him as a pet. Huh?
George, you already have two pets. And you have a hard enough time taking care of them.
But he'll be a good playmate for Shep. Shep, play nice. This little fella's part of our family now. George will call him Shep.
George, that name is taken?
Oh, right. Then how about Little Shep?
Is this really necessary?
Anteater needs to rest his little paws.
Help! Help!
Let's go, Shep. Whoop, we can't forget Little Shep. George and Shep and Baby make three.
Help! Help!
Stairs, Shep, stairs!
Help!
Shep, be more careful. Good little Shep! From now on, little Shep comes with George on all rescues.
We want to see the little baby.
Aww.
Shep, can you move a little bit? You're blocking this cutie.
We got you some treats. And a pretty collar. And a sweater for those chilly jungle nights.
Aw, he likes you.
Oh, you brought him back.
Hey, let go!
Ape, I think little Shep wants a snack.
Okay, but just... Hey! One.
Hey, George.
George, fine. Think I'll go to doctor and get a new shoulder.
Yay! We'll babysit Mr. Cute Stuff.
We will?
Yes! Okay, sweetie stuff. Time for a scrubby scrub.
We got soap in our eyes.
Cute. I think he's getting a tooth.
Yeah! Oh, I can confirm that. Oh.
Must be why he's so cranky.
I know what'll relax him. A jungle lullaby.
Something for little Shep's teething.
I suggest good old-fashioned hypnosis.
Rubbish. He just needs a little numbing gel.
I'll prove this works.
I'll prove it doesn't work.
Well, I'll prove this doesn't work. See?
I am at your command. I am at your command.
Here, this one says baby medicine. Let's see, may cause drowsiness. Oh, well, that wouldn't be so bad. Open up.
Just open your mouth like this.
Good news, General.
Somebody's having a picnic?
No, even better. That elephant who knocked the top off our anthill has made it up to us.
Marshmallows. Give it, give it, give it!
Little Shep would never do that.
It's true. He's evil.
George can't hear you. George can't hear you. Also, can't smell you.
George, take your fingers out of your nose and listen. Wait. What's that sound?
It's either a parade or an attacking army of ants. Oh, shoot. I love parades.
There's too many of them!
Shep will rescue us.
Go get him!
Retreat! Retreat!
George is proud of you. Oh, you too, little chap. There you go. Here's your mommy.
Oh, you are so grounded, young man.
Good doggy.
Okay.
The king of the jungle doesn't interrupt his lunchtime for just anything.
Stop! Stop!
Is it a cry for help?
Stop!
Are two enemies locked in mortal combat?
Stop! Stop!
Or is it the annual birthday bash of Howie the Howler Monkey? Make a wish!
Look at that! It's a great big party, and you get a cake, a fire, and you get a bucking rhinoceros!
Hmm, sounds like you're talking about a birthday party.
Oh, yes! A birthday party! What's a birthday?
A party for your birthday? Remember?
Oh, George is having a hard time remembering something that's never happened.
You've never had a birthday party, have you? George, I haven't had a crisp, crunchy termite all day. Could you get me one?
Oh, sure.
Thank you.
I thought you were afraid of termites.
Ape, I can't believe George has never had a birthday party.
We don't really know when he was born.
I thought he was the same age as you.
How old are you anyway?
In ape years, I'm 5.
The happiest memories of my whole life are at my birthday parties.
Mine too?
Here we go! Crispy, crunchy termite! Hey, what's wrong?
Termite!
George, knock it off!
Oh, come on! Giddy up!
No!
Please!
No!
Please!
No!
Please!
Please! No!
We have got to throw George his own birthday party. We've got to get him a present. It's got to be something so perfect. It makes up for all the years he's never had a birthday.
Whatever it is, he'll be plenty surprised.
I'm getting a bucking rhino! Sleeping. Sleeping.
Well, he doesn't need loincloths.
Or anything rhino related.
Oh. Anyway, I guess we'll have to brainstorm and come up with some ideas of our own. So what did you get for George?
A 6-in-1 frog zapper. It's a frog and it catches flies.
Don't all frogs catch flies?
But this one also catches mosquitoes, licks envelopes, changes light bulbs, and picks up coins that fall behind the dresser.
That's 5 things.
Maybe number 6 is it gives you warts.
I got your cheese. Now who wouldn't love these?
What'd you get him?
Something practical. Something he's always needed.
Shorts? George has a thing about pockets.
Help! Help!
George to the rescue! Let's see. Rescue manual. Sandwich. Banana. First aid kit. Up. Second aid kit. Compass. 6-in-1 frog zapper. Cookie bird. After sandwich snack. Drink.
Help already!
Oh!
Let's just make him a nice fruit basket.
Everybody wants some kind of present.
And we can't give him a birthday party until we make up our minds about what to give him.
A bucking rhino! George wants a bucking rhino!
Is that George spying on us?
No,
no! It's just us ostriches! Look, 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 look.
Come on, that is not what we sound like.
No!
George is gonna love the gift we're getting him.
Why, it's exactly what he wanted.
And he'll never think to look at the top of Mount Way up there.
My fucking rhino!
At least now we can figure out what to get him in peace.
Friends hide George's present really well. Huh. Oh, nothing up here but this giraffe. Hey, wait a minute! Giraffe must be gift! Woohoo! I love it! A bucking giraffe is even better than a bucking rhino!
When we find the perfect gift for George, we'll know it.
That's it!
Okay, bucking giraffe! I told you I'm not your birthday present. Oh, no! George, not that easily fooled. Giddy up! Hey, quit kicking!
Well, I've only got one to sell you, but I was just talking to another customer about it today.
Then we're just in time. We want it. We'll take it.
Well, my other customer can be pretty persuasive. Do you know El Grunty?
Yeah. Why?
He's the other customer.
Senor Howie, I have decided I must have the mechanical bucking rhino.
Actually, El Grunty, I was just about to sell the last one to my friends here.
Yeah, sorry. We just bought it.
No, my friend. It is I who am sorry. For whatever El Grunty wants, El Grunty gets. We duel. Whoever rides bucking rhino longest shall take home the prize.
Great. Magnolia?
Ape!
Well, okay. What could possibly go wrong?
Oh, come on! I won't tell I found you before my birthday! George, I'm not lying! I'm just up here having a bite to eat! Oh, come on! Buck now! Eat later! Yeah! Right him, giraffe boy! Whee!
That does it.
Woohoo! This is more like it!
Hooray! 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 Invigorating.
A new jungle record! 6 hours, 38 minutes.
The saddle is still warm, Senor Ape.
All right, then. Whoa. Hey. Okay.
This is easy.
Yes. The warm-up period is quite easy. It should be up to full speed soon.
Oh, dear.
George would like cargo shorts, wouldn't he?
The earrings I got him would look very elegant if he wore the right shoes. You win, sir.
Holy!
Happy first birthday!
This is the best birthday George has ever had. Ape gave me this frog thingy.
Oh, you're welcome.
Magnolia gave me these beautiful earrings. And look at all those pockets. My... Thank you, Ursula.
You're welcome.
But my best present of all is the visit from my old pal, El Grunty.
What?
Happy first birthday, old friend. I hope you like your present.
My fucking rhino! Giddy up!
Deep in the jungle, shut off from the conveniences of modern life, animals and man alike must create their own forms of entertainment. Like snake ball.
Incoming! Missed!
Oh, yeah?
Oh no! Witch doctor's witch doctoring witch doctor stick!
Ah!
Can Beaver chew this into a copy of a witch doctor stick?
Sorry. I just ate a hoagie. Too full, eh?
Close enough. Tasty.
Making a stew for me, for you. The taste is like a doggy's stew. I can fix that. Making a stew for me, for you. Yeah, past its expiration. Now, where'd I leave my witch doctor witch doctrine stick? Oh, ha! There it is. Now back to my stew that won't taste like dog stew.
It's just a stick. What's the worst that could happen? So, George has a question. What would happen if your dad's witch doctor witch doctoring stick got broken, huh?
My dad's witch doctoring stick is broken?
Oh, no, 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 no! George was just wondering, that's all.
Oh, phew! Because my dad always told me that if anything happens to that stick, the jungle will be destroyed by evil spirits. Stop doing that!
So, how does Squirrel think evil spirits will destroy jungle? Earthquake? Tornado? Giant theme park with high-priced parking?
Nah, I'm thinking a giant monster eats everything in its path. Plants, animals, people, everything.
and then the entire jungle digests slowly in its gut.
Hi there!
Oops.
Oh, I'll get to it in a minute. What can I do for you, George?
George needs help figuring out how to move something.
What kind of something?
Oh, the jungle. Just for a change of scenery, you know?
When I want a change of scenery, I just back up the old camper. Because there's no...
Remember how everyone always says they want to go camping?
Not young.
No. No, I don't.
Right! So... Surprise camping trip!
Where are we going?
Someplace far away, so that when the jungle gets eaten to bits, we'll...
Eaten to bits?
George said jungle is made of bits. Yeah, but now it's one big bit.
But what are the other animals gonna do without us?
George, way ahead of Ape.
What's a food court?
Road trip!
George, there's no motor on this thing.
Right! As George pulled his friends to safety, he found renewed strength, even though his intense guilt slowly festered inside him. Or it may have been all that trail mix.
I gotta go to the bathroom again.
You know, it is kind of peaceful out here.
Peaceful? Really? Oh, well, that's just what they want Ape to think while they plan our destruction.
I think you need more trail mix.
68 bunches of bananas on the trees, 68 bunches of bananas. If one falls down, pass it around. 67 bunches of bananas on the trees. Everybody!
Are we there yet?
I'm getting car sick. I'm kidding. No, I'm serious.
This trip is officially not fun.
Why are we stopping, George?
George sees an evil-looking rock.
Neat! Can we go now?
One moment! That's one evil spirit who won't get us. George will save you! Uh-oh.
Now this trip is officially way not fun.
Great! Now we're stuck in the middle of nowhere.
No problem. George will get us back home. All righty, let's move them out.
It's like sitting in traffic, but there is no traffic.
George, I know you wanted to have a nice trip, but maybe we should just go home?
Yeah, I really miss home.
Be right back.
I gotta go to the bathroom again.
We'll be here when you get back.
Keep your eyes covered. George has big surprise.
I hope it's a bathroom with toilet paper.
Okay, open your eyes.
We're home? I'm going to wash my hair.
No! George thinks we should just stand right here for a while and not touch anything.
Sorry, George, but I'm really hungry.
Surprise! Again!
Tough.
told you it wouldn't work.
George, what are we doing here?
We wanna go back to the jungle!
You can't! And it's all George's fault!
What?
Oh, George broke Witch Doctor's witch doctoring stick! So now, evil spirits are gonna eat the jungle! And us!
Oh, I made that up when Magnolia was little, so she wouldn't mess with my stuff. I have hundreds of these things. I break them all the time and nothing happens. Go ahead. See? Nothing.
Hey! You're right!
Evil spirits.
Okay.
In the jungle, no sight is sweeter than a new mama bird and her new baby bird egg. Especially if you're a hungry snake.
Alarm clock is the best gift Ape ever gave George.
I didn't give that to you. That monkey just doesn't like you.
Yeah. Hmm? Hey, an egg.
Ooh, an egg. Well, let's see. We could have some omelets or a frittata.
No, George must have laid this egg last night.
Did you just say you laid an egg?
Yup. A man egg!
How can I explain this? Ah, I know. You can't lay an egg.
I can talk like an animal. I can smell like an animal. Why can't you believe I can lay an egg like an animal?
How about the fact that you're a guy, huh? How about that?
George is going to take care of man egg. And when a little George comes out of it, we'll see which one of us looks like an overgrown monkey.
Fine. But an egg is delicate. You're worse than a water buffalo in a china shop.
Mm. What beautiful craftsmanship.
Man egg, come. Oh, he's just tired.
Oh.
That's better.
Oh,
I got you now.
Can I see the baby? Hi there, cutie. I'm Magnolia, your pretty aunt. And that is Ursula. She's your other aunt.
George, I think that diaper is kind of unnecessary.
Oh, time for potty training already?
No, I mean, I don't think an egg needs that much attention.
Sure, just sit on it till it hatches. Ooh, I just can't wait to see a whole man come out of that egg.
An egg!
What?
Hi, George. How's the egg sitting?
George just thinking about all the fun he'll have with little George.
a girl? A bleat for help! George has to go!
But what about your egg?
George will take it with him.
You can't take a delicate little egg with you. It's too dangerous.
It's gotta learn about rescue sometime. Also, long division. Very important.
Help! Help!
Okay, one moment. Nope. Oh, nice and comfy. There you go. Hey! Get away from that man egg! Remember, never to talk to Swap! No! Was a gunner when that hyena found it. And it was just luck when George found it in that egg fruit grove.
You lost it?
George still can't believe it wasn't eaten by the vulture who took it. Oh, or smashed with clubs by the chimps.
That's terrible!
George, as king of the jungle, you have too many dangerous duties to take care of this egg.
Oh. Okay. For safety of little George.
Magnolia, you're hogging the egg.
Am not.
Are so.
Hey, I have a fun idea. Let's use this time to get to know each other a little better instead of arguing.
Sometimes in the morning, George's breath smells like bologna.
Okay. Go back to arguing.
Am not.
Are so.
Am not.
You are.
George is so lonely without Man Egg.
Am not.
Are so.
Am not.
Are so.
You know, Ape, you could stand to trim your toenails now and then.
What are you talking about?
They're scratching me.
My toes are nowhere near you.
Are so.
Are not.
Are so.
Wait. Those aren't Ape's toenails.
It's hatching. It's not a man. It's a bird? Weird.
Whoa! Get that semi-hatched egg!
I hope it doesn't fall and break its shell!
And I hope the hyena had lunch already!
Ah! Where's the egg?
Man egg, you're back! And you have feet!
Wow. I guess he took better care of it than we thought.
Well, sure. What'd you expect? I break it? Hey,
Cookie, cookie?
Hello, little George.
Tookie, tookie.
Oh, okay. Hello, tookie, tookie. Oh, you're welcome. Well, sure. Tookie Tookie can visit George whenever he wants. And that's the story of how George met Tookie.
Oh, Tookie Tookie.
Ah, the jungle at night. Soothing.
And jazzy.
Bongos!
I sincerely hope this is a bad dream.
George just want Ape to get good rest.
Bongos! But everyone in the jungle knows what bongos do to me.
Ape, stay here while George investigates.
I tried telling him, George.
Open to another music lover.
Yeah, why isn't Big Mitch at the temple?
Sad story. Just when things were finally going good at the temple.
Hey, quit hogging the cheese.
I found my old set of bongos. Any requests? Guess you have to be alive to appreciate good music, huh? Tossed out of my own ancient golden temple with nothing but my beloved bongos. But for now, let's party! Give it to me. Bingo, bingo, bongo time!
I thought you were gonna take care of it.
Oh, Big Mitch just got tossed out of his home. Don't worry, George has other plans. Aha!
I do not approve of this plan.
But, George, you can't solve all your problems by putting your friends in a block of cement.
Why not? Ape can still talk, and George can feed him and hold his book up so he can read, and...
I have to go to the bathroom.
Oh.
What you want to do is distract Big Mitch with another instrument.
George doesn't have any instruments.
My voice is considered an instrument.
By who?
Me?
Oh.
what happened. George was supposed to take care of Mitch.
Oh, Mitch taught me how to sing like a rock star. Isn't that so awesome? Gonna do it again.
This means war.
Bongo moisturizer keeps your bongo skin soft. How thoughtful! What the? Glue! You can't stop a porn entertainer from entertaining! This calls for the bicycle.
What is that? What is that sound?
It's called silence, George. And you'd better get used to it, because that's the way it's gonna be from now on.
Here we go again! A one, and a two, and a three!
Ape tipped over Big Mitch's tree?
George, something had to be done.
There were a lot of animals in that tree.
Ah, it's better for them to find a new home where they don't have to listen to those awful bongos.
Good, because George invited all the animals to come stay with us.
Huh? Hello! What do you have to do to get some breakfast around here?
Go! You're in my house, and I make the rules, and the first rule is no bongo playing. These animals need a new tree.
Any vacancies?
Sure.
Great. Are they available right away?
I just need to do a background check, get references clean, and rebark. Oh, and no marmosets. Named Mitch.
Whoa! Big tree? How come George not smack into it before?
It looks empty, George. Do you know what this means?
George gets his own bed back?
Sorry, Big Mitch no can do this.
That's too bad. Because if you do move into this tree, you can have your bongos back.
Oh! Yeah, give me my bongos!
Tree first, then bongos.
Slick. Very slick. Fine, I'll do it.
Yeah! Peace and quiet at last.
We can't stand the bongos anymore!
All this evicting gets me in a partying mood! Can I get a what? What? Holla!
Get him! Come here!
Okay, fellas, we can work this out. I mean, you wouldn't hurt a musician, would you? No!
Oh,
Now see what you did? If you just...
We told you we don't want you and your annoying bongos in this temple anymore.
I am offended, sir. My drum thingy playing is one of the highest caliber.
Hey, cut that out!
How do you do that?
Every time I hear bongos and...
Ape loves to dance. Great exercise for mummies, too.
My bandages are getting a little tight.
That looks like fun! Let me try!
I love it! Keep playing!
Here we go! Holla! Put your hands in the air! Wave them like you just don't care!
This is fun! George should get instrument!
No bongos! George! George! George!